today I'm here with a new video, and today I am here with, is it my third part or fourth part in my decluttering series? Today we are finally doing eyeshadow palettes. I can't even remember if I ever have done an eyeshadow palette collection here on my channel, I don't know. But today is the time. It's going to be an eyeshadow palette collection and also an eyeshadow palette decluttering. And the palettes that I will declutter, I will give away to friends and family, so don't ask me about any of the palettes. And yeah, I think we just hop into this. And I don't know how many palettes I have, so just let's begin to my eyeshadow palette collection. So I'm trying to take this in alphabetic order, and I hope it will work. So I'm going to start with A. And A's Beauté is the first one I have. So I have 5 palettes from A's Beauté. And I think I just get started. So I have this Vintage Dawn. This one, I do love the color story. The actual, like, quality of this palette isn't as good as the other palettes I have from Ace Beauté, but I will keep this because I do like it. I also have the Scarlet Dusk, that is the same, like, smaller palette from them. And this one I do like so much more than the Vintage Dawn. I think this is a really good pinkish lean palette, so I keep this one as well. Oceanic, love it. It's an amazing green and blue palette. It's also staying. The Flare palette is, I love this one. I think it's really, really good. I have no problems with the formula whatsoever. I think it's a really good palette, and I've actually used it quite a lot. So it's staying as well. And then the newest one I have from Ace Beauté is the Nostalgia. And this I have only used one. I did a collab video with my friend Anna, and this one is staying because I want to use this more. So nothing to decluttering from Ace Beauté. The next one is Anastasia Beverly Hills, and I have 4 palettes from them. And I will actually decluttering the Modern Renaissance. I haven't used this much at all. I bought it so long after, like, the hype with Anastasia, because these wasn't my kind of colors, and it still isn't. So I'm actually decluttering this one. Haven't used it much, maybe like 6 times or something, so this will actually go. I don't know where to put the palettes that are going. This is the Prism palette. This was one of their holiday palettes. I can't remember when. A long time ago. So it's no longer available. It hasn't been for a lot of years. But I do actually really like this palette, so I'm going to keep this. I wish that they would do something similar to this one, but I guess it's not going to happen. The subculture palette, I have never had any problems with this at all. I did not understand all the hate this palette got, so this is staying. And the Soft Glam is also staying. This is my favorite palette, I think, from Anastasia. This is the one that I use the most, and I just think this is a really good palette. It's a really nice neutral palette. So this I will keep. BH Cosmetics. This summer I bought 5 of their Sweet Shop palettes. I did a super long video about them, and all of these are staying because I think they are really, really good. So I thought that I can just show you them quickly. So it's the green one, the Pistachio. Such a nice green palette. The Cotton Candy, the pink and the purple. Also amazing. The blue one, Bubblegum. Really good blues. The Cherry on Top, the red one. I wish this was a little bit more red, but I do like it. And also the Sweet Orange. dark orange one. So all of these are staying. I love them so, so much. I just need to use them more. From Black Moon Cosmetics, I have the Orb of Light palette, and this, I have used this a few times. I have done one video with it, and then I've used some of the colors like together with others. And this is a really nice palette. Maybe not the most fun one, but it will stay in my collection just because I do like it. From a Beauté Bay, I have two palettes. I have the Nikki Tutorials palettes, and mine is making me crazy because you can see it's not like here. Not super like tight and closed. It looks like this. I bought it on sale. I've used it 2 times. I'm not super big fan of Nikki. Like, I have nothing bad to say about her at all. But I like don't know. I think I actually will decluttering this one because it's not the palette that I use. I haven't used all the shimmers, and like this shimmer looks really good. Yeah, it does. But I think I have this in other palettes. Okay, I can't swatch things because then I'm going to be all dirty. So I actually think that I will decluttering this one. I will put this in a maybe pile. And then we will see. So I put this in a maybe. Then the Wilderness palette. This one I did not love. But I did not hate it either. So I think that I actually will keep this one, use it more, and see what I feel. I think I just need to give it like one more try before I decide to not keep it. So the Wilderness is staying. The next brand is Blush Tribe, that is no longer available. I did really, really love Blush Tribe. And yeah. So if we start with Blossom, this one, I will not keep this one. I don't think the formula was super good. Some of the colors are so, so good. Like Clover was really good. And I think it was this Sunflower and like this one, but some of the other are so, so bad. So I will decluttering this one. I've been thinking about it for a long time, so this is going to be decluttered. Then I have the Fall Fusion palette that looks like this, and I actually don't know. I've done some amazing looks with these three, like a really nice orangey look, and the shimmers are good, but I don't know. I haven't used this for so long. So this will go in the maybe pile. I have the Hasina palette. This is a really nice palette, and I did 3 looks 1 palette with this one, and this was really fun to play with. But I actually think that I have these colors in other palettes that I use more. So this is going in a maybe pile as well. But the Hasina 2 palette, this is going nowhere. And yeah, I know, this is a green and purple palette and a little bit of blue, but like this reshade is one of my absolute favorite shades in my collection. So this one is staying. And I have the Munasa palette, and this, I'm so sorry. I don't like the background. I do like these colors, the ones that I've used, because they were really good. But the background, it takes a lot away from the shadows. So I think it's really hard to like see them. And I think I actually will decluttering this one, because I haven't used it more like than 2 times maybe. Because the background is throwing me off. And I don't use Blush Tribe that much on my channel, like at all, if I'm going to be honest. So I will decluttering this one. But the Paulina palette, the collab palette between Blush Tribe and Paulina Beauty, this will go nowhere. I do love this palette. I have followed Paulina for, I think, since she started her YouTube channel. So this is going nowhere. This one I am keeping. Okay, then we have Colourpop, and this is all of my 9 pan palettes. So I guess I have some 12 palettes as well, but I think I will start with these. So we can start with the monochromatic palettes that I have. So the orange, you're glad. This palette, I love orange. I'm not like super pleased with this palette. I think they could have done a more fun orange palette, but I will keep it just because I do like orange. The Blue Moon palette, this is one of my favorite blue palettes. I am not a super fan of blue, but this one is so, so good. The only thing is my palette, like the magnet behind them, it's just like a row or like a strip of magnet, so it's getting loose in the ends. But yeah, I will keep the Blue Moon as well. I will also keep the Ooh-La-La, or will I? Maybe not, actually. Is this so special? I did like it when I've used it, but I actually think that I might declutter the Ooh-La-La, so I will keep this in my maybe pile. Just my luck palette is going nowhere. I love this green palette. I love how grunge it is. I love like this one and this one as well. This is like a dirty grungy green, so this one is staying. The palette I hate the name of, honey. I think this was a kind of boring yellow palette, and it is a pressed glitter in it, but I will keep this one because I do like yellow. I have the lilac hue a lot. I think I've only used this once. It's so hard to open. It looks like this. But I actually think that I will keep this one. Yeah, this will stay. And then the last one, it's kind of dirty, is the Mint to Be. And I actually think I will keep this one as well. I just need to use it more. Then I have this in the tie-dye set. And I have only used the orange out. And I was not impressed by this at all. So I'm going to declutter this one. And then I have the Inner Trance. This is unused. Never been touched. And I have had it for 1.5 years. Even like the plastic is still on the mirror, so I'm decluttering this one. I will do the same with Miss Bliss because I haven't used this either, and I think I will just use these two once and then not be so happy with them. So both of these are going as well. The last 4 9 pens I have is the Old Mar palette. They changed the front of this. It looks like this. This is like such a boring palette, so I'm decluttering this one. This is a really nice shade, but I'm not going to keep this one. And the Soul palette, it's the same with that. I think these were like the first 9 pen palettes in like this plastic they did. I'm not going to keep this either because I haven't used it for so long. The Mandalorian, the Child palette, this is kind of new to me. I'm keeping it. I liked it the first time, wasn't like super amazed with it, but it's staying. And also Sparkle a Little Magic, the Tinker Bitch collab. I do love this palette. This has such a cool color story. It's so grungy. It has these really dark shades. This is of course staying. And I have more Colourpop than this. I also have some of their bigger palettes. So maybe I should take these in two. The Yes Please palette. This was one of the first palettes I did buy from Colourpop. I have really liked it. It has some really, really nice shades. But I'm declaring this one. I haven't used it for so, so long. Maybe once last year. I don't think I've used it this year. So I'm decluttering this one. I have the Zodiac palette that was a collab with Kathleen Lights. I have a hard time with this palette because some of the shades are so, so good. Like this Gemini is really good, the Leo, and these matte ones. But some of the shimmers are so bad, like the Pisces. My shade, of course, isn't super amazing. But I actually think that I would keep this just because, like, this Gemini is one of my favorite gold shades. So I will keep this. Even though I don't like, I never think I watched Kathleen Lights once. I have the California Love. This is a really nice palette. I have used it a few times. It will stay. Or should I put it in a maybe pile? No, it will stay. The Lush Life. I have used this once. And the background. Sorry. I will keep this one. I want to use it more. Because I know that a lot of people really love this. So I just want to use it more. Whatever is staying. This is an amazing palette from Colourpop. It is such a dark, dark palette. And it's such good quality on these dark shadows. So the Whatever is staying. Sweet Talk is also staying. This is a really neutral, peachy leaning palette. This is really good. I love this summer. So it's staying. The same with Good Sports, of course. This is one of my absolute favorite shades, this Ebb. I do love the shimmers in this one. The mattes aren't super good, all of them. But Good Sport, I'm going to keep it. The Powerpuff Girls. I'm decluttering this one. I have used it once in a video. I wished for more with this. So yeah, I'm actually decluttering this one, even though I love the Powerpuff Girls. So happy about this palette, but I think it's kind of boring. So I'm decluttering this one. Then the Raw Beauty Christie and Colourpop at First Sight. I think I only used this once as well, but I want to use it more. So this is staying. I do really like how this look. And has this been leaking, or are you supposed to look like that? No, you're supposed to look like that. I'm keeping this one. So that was all Colourpop. I have two palettes from Certifeye. I have the Tropical Wonders, the All Matte Rainbow Palette. This is really good, but I have another rainbow palette that I rather keep than this one. So I'm decluttering this one. And the same with the Dynasty palette. I think I've used this twice. Or maybe four times. It is good, but it's not staying. And now I think I need to sneeze again. From Colored Raine, I have two palettes. I have the Queen of Hearts palette. This I have been really loving. But the last time I used it, some of the matte shadows has dried up, so I'm going to decluttering this one because the quality is not there anymore. I do have been really liking it, but I'm going to decluttering this one. But I am going to keep the Vivid Pigments. I have these as loose, as like singles. Now they are in the palette, but I have them when they were singles. These are really good, some of them. Some of them are kind of dry and a little bit harder to work with. But yeah, I do like them. So this is going to stay in my collection. I have three palettes from a Swedish brand. And I actually do have two more palettes from this brand that is on its way to me. But like, I can't wait any longer to do this decluttering video. And I really want to do this. So I was just like, fuck it, I'm going to do this. So this is the Swedish brand GlossGods, and I got the Making It Flawless. I do like this palette. I think it has some really nice shimmers down here. It is staying. And also this little rainbow palette. I did a collab with a Swedish YouTuber named Sofie last year in my vlogmas thingy. Going to keep this one as well. And I'm also going to have this. This is Touch Me. And yeah, I do really like this palette as well. So these are staying. I have a little eyeshadow palette from H&M. This is not going to stay. This is like a little holographic eyeshadow palette, but this is going. It's really nice to use as an inner corner, but I'm not keeping this one. Another palette from a Swedish brand that I got from a friend is IsaDora, and this is 5 shimmers. Finding it hard to declutter in gifts I have gotten, but this one, I will not keep it because I'm not using it, so I will decluttering this one. Okay, now we're going into Juvia's place, and I don't really know how to do this. I can start with these small 6 pans I have. I have the nudes. I have used this once. I'm going to decluttering this one. The chocolates I have used once. Wasn't super like amazed. I think I've used 3 colors in this. I'm going to decluttering this one as well. The violets I haven't even used. I have had it for 1.5 years. So I am going to decluttering this one. I have other purples that I do like. I haven't used this. I haven't been like looking forward to use it, so I'm decluttering this one. And the same with the berries. I think I have used, I at least have touched this one and this one, but I don't think I've used this one, so I'm going to decluttering this one as well. And don't try to tell me that these palettes are good, because I have made up my mind. I'm going to decluttering these 4. And now the decluttering pile is getting kinda high. I have more Juvia's place. This is the Zulu palette. This was one of my first rainbow palettes. I don't use it that much, but I'm going to keep it because of sentimental reasons. The Decay. if you know, I do not like this palette that much, but I'm going to keep it. There is some colors in this that I really like. I like the crepe shade, the puffs, creme, tart, and chocolate. So I'm keeping this one as well. The Try palette. This is going nowhere. This is one of my absolute favorite palettes from Juvia's Place. I'm keeping this. The Festival palette. I do like this, so it's staying. The Warrior 3. I have used this once. I wasn't like super amazed with it, and I do actually think I haven't used all the shades, but I think I will decluttering this one. I don't think I will miss anything if I do decluttering it, so I will actually declutter this. The Nomad I will keep. I love the grunchiness of this one, so it will stay in my collection. And the same goes for the Saharan 2 palette. I do think this is a really nice palette with really dark mattes down here, and the shimmers are really good as well. So this one will actually stay. And then I have 4 more palettes from Juvia's Place. So the Saharan 1. I do like the shimmers in this one. Like, this is a really nice shade. But I actually think that this will go. I don't use it that much, and I don't think there is shades in this one that I feel like I need to have. So I will decluttering that. The Nubian 2. I bought this for not that long time ago. It is one of their older palettes, but I actually will keep this one. The Mini Masquerade. I think this will go, actually. I like that, like, the half of the palette is colorful and the other half is more neutral. But I'm missing some matte colorful palettes. Colorful, matte colorful in this one. It is absolutely amazing shimmers. But I will decluttering this one. And then the Magic palette. I hate that I have the big one. But I will keep this, I think. The shimmers in this are really, really good. This gold one is amazing. So I will keep this Juvia's Place palette. And the next brand is Kaleidos, and here nobody is going. Nobody is allowed to leave me. And I don't know, maybe I can show you the palettes I have. I've gotten some of these in PR. I bought some of these myself. So this is the Cyber Bronze, an amazing red shimmer. Love this. I can't put it there. Sashimi City, their most like neutral palette. Astro Pink, really nice pinkish leaning with amazing shimmers. Lunar Lavender, I did like this actually, even though I'm not super big fan of purple. People that are super big fan of purple doesn't seem to like this, but I do. Electro Turquoise looks like this. VR Neon, this is discontinued. I don't know what they were thinking. It's a really nice colorful palette. Certifeye Green, amazing shimmers in this one, and an amazing black shadow. And then I of course have these. This is the Flower Punk. Hate the packaging, love the palette. The Escape Pod, I have the old bulky one that I don't seem to know how to open. This is growing on me for every time I use it, so this will definitely stay, because all Kaleidos are staying. And one of my favorite palettes I have in my collection, the Club Nebula. I'm so sorry for you that missed this one. It is an amazing palette. It is collaboration with my friend Nilka Nyqvist and Kaleidos. I love this one. Then we can maybe go into a controversial brand, KVD, whatever they are called. I have the Metal Mini, I think it's called. That looks like this. I have swatched this. And this shade looks a little bit funky. I've swatched this. I am not going to keep it. So no. But then the Saint and Sinner, I'm going to keep this one. It's so bulky, but I think this is so cool. So this is staying. I also have the 10 years anniversary palette, and this like came out when shit hit the fan. I do think this is kind of a good palette. Maybe a little bit too many shadows, and I actually think that I will declutter in this one. And then the Shade and Light eye palette. This, when this came to Sweden to Sephora, people were crazy. This is like such a boring eyeshadow palette. I will declutter in this one as well. I do not get the hype. I don't even know if I get it or if I just bought it because everybody did. Maybe, but I'm decluttering this one. I have this palette from L.A. Splash, the Classic Horror. I don't use this, but it's something about this. I think I will keep this one and try to use it. And if I don't use it at all next year, I'm going to declutter this one. But for so long, it will stay. Then it's time for one of my other favorite brands, which is Lethal. And I have quite a few palettes from Lethal. So I have their first collab palette, the Yulina palette. This is staying. I have done quite a few looks with this. I do like it, but it's nothing that I take out and play with. But it is staying in my collection. I have one of their newest, Berlin 89. It's also staying. It is a multichrome here. I love that one. So this is staying as well. I think all of my Lethals stay. This is one of their 6-pan palettes. It's the Memento. I do really, really like this little pink palette. Then I have the Velvet Dusk. an amazing grungy 90s inspired palette. Starting to love this so much. The 80s palette, the After Dark, that I can't seem to open. I don't know what to say, but it's good. The collab with Teresa is dead, Lethal is dead. I think it's so fun that they did a collab with Teresa, and I do like this palette. I think I have a little bit hard time to come up with looks to do with it, but I do like it, and I will have it. Then I have my three palettes with singles. I thought that I can show you them. So here I have just tried to make like a green palette. I don't know what I put in. Yeah, it's my blue, green, and a little bit pink and purple palette. I have done a lot of videos with my singles from Lethal. I can leave my playlist up in corner. And yeah, that one as well. So these are all staying. Next brand that I have a lot of palettes from is LH Cosmetics. And here also everybody's staying. Nobody's going. Nobody is allowed to leave. And I do miss one palette. The Infinity palette. My most used palette ever. I used this for my face. This is absolutely staying. I have the Infinity Deep. This I love the front of this, and I love the inside as well. The Spectral palette. I need to use this more because this is such a cool palette. And I hope that I will use my palettes more now when I have done a little decluttering. This is the Infinity Glam. This is also a really nice palette. I don't use it that much, but it's really good. And then this was the rainbow palette that I talked about. The color palette from LH Cosmetics. I'm in the process of using all the shadows. I've used half of the palette, and I do really, really like this. So this is, of course, staying. Then I have the Little Quads. The Enchanted Mysteries. I think it's this one that is a multi-chrome. But yeah, it's going nowhere. The Metallic Mysteries, this was their first one. Metallic Mysteries 2. I love this red one and this green one. They are so nice. And the Enchanted Secrets, this one. And this is also staying, of course. Then I have two palettes from Lime Crime, Venus 2. And this is a really cool little grunge palette. I'm keeping this one. And a Preload Chroma. I do really like this. Even though it maybe doesn't look much to the world, but I'm keeping this one as well. Then we have Lunar Beauty. And here I will also keep all the palettes. So I have the Greek Goddess. This one is really, really good palette. I think this is discontinued, but it's really, really good. I have the Strawberry Dream. But you know what? Maybe? I maybe could declutter this one. I think it's good, but it's not amazing. I will put this in a maybe pile, and we will see. The Moonspell, though, it's going nowhere. I think this is a really, really good palette. I love that it's purple row, a neutral row, and a greenish row. So this will stay, and I love the front of it. And Eternal Eclipse. Now it's really dirty on the table. It's a really dark, nice palette. And this is also staying. And then from Louis Cosmetics, I have the Meet Me in the Underworld. I do really like this. I did 3 looks, 1 palette, and I start to like the palette the longer. Like, in the first look, I thought it was okay. In the second look I liked it more, and after the third look I liked it a little bit more. I've used it sometimes outside of YouTube, and this does really start to grow on me. I think it's really, really good. So this will definitely staying, and I love the packaging. I love the color story. I love everything about it, and I start to like the colors more and more, and the most of the shimmers are really, really amazing. From Makeup Geek, I have one palette and some singles. The palette I have is a super old collab with Manny MUA. It looks like this. I will keep this one because I do like it. I don't even want to know how old it is, but I'm going to keep this. From Makeup Addiction, I have this one. This is such an amazing palette. The shimmers are outstanding. The mattes are so, so good. I'm going to keep this one because I do really, really like it. I think that Makeup Addiction should just... I don't know, they do amazing eyeshadow palettes, but like they never release anything, and I don't know, but this is an amazing palette, so I will keep it. Okay, they're almost in alphabetic order. But then from Menagerie, I'm going to keep, I think, all of these. I have the Whale Song palette that I can't open. That looks like this. This has two amazing grungy shades, Kelp and Plankton. The shimmers are really good, especially like Fluke and Pearl. This is a really good palette. I can't remember if they did discontinue this or not. I don't know, but it is a really good palette. The Killer Pearl, it is not my favorite palette from Menagerie, but I do like it. But yeah, it will stay for this time. Maybe in my next decluttering it will go. We will see. The Serenity palette, this is going nowhere. This is a collab between Menagerie and then its Makeup Corner. This has been one of my favorite palettes I've tried this year. The shimmers are amazing. The mattes are really, really good. These two light ones are really, really good. And I think this is a really good palette. So this will stay. The Pastel Pop will also stay. It's not my favorite pastel palette, but with this together with the Creepy Cute from Shroud, I have all the pastels I need. The Feral palette, this is a good palette. It's not super great, but it is a good palette. So we keep it. And then the Dragon Child. We have had our... I did not like this palette at first. I learned to like it. I learned to use it. So this will stay. I think it's a really cool color story. And... it has some really nice shades. Some of them are a little bit tricky, but color story overall is just amazing. Then we can go over to Melt. And here I have mostly... what is it even called? Holiday palettes. I have the Smoke Session. I think this is a really cool color story. I hate the theme of it, but I will keep it. Just because, like, these shimmers are amazing. So this will stay as well. The Muerte Vida palette is going nowhere. And the Muerte one. People, this is like one of these palettes that people are sad that they missed out of. I can understand why. It's a really dark, nice palette. Not all the shadows are amazing, but it is a really cool palette. The same with the Vida palette. Not all colors are amazing, but it is a really cool palette. I am so happy that I bought these. And then the last year's holiday palette from Melt is the Beetlejuice. I do love Beetlejuice. This is the Waiting Room palette. I can't open. The red one. I wished it was more red and not that many grays, but it is what it is. Staying as well. And then the Recently Deceased. I think this is such a good palette. I just wished it was a little bit bigger, but I do really like this one, so it's staying. Then I have my Nabla palettes. I'm going to start with this Miami Light Glitter Palette. I'm not super big fan of this, but it's Nabla, so I'm going to keep it. And I'm not going to decluttering any other of my Nabla palettes. I have all the little cutie palettes. I did a cutie week. This is one of my favorite cutie palettes. It's the Platinum. Love this one. Such a cool little palette. The Analog. It's a really good darker nude palette. Wildberry, that I start to like more after my Nabla week. I love that when I do my theme weeks. But this is... I wished it was a lighter background. I think the shadows would have popped more. But it is a really nice palette. And one that I don't like that much, the blue one. Just because I don't like blue. The Metropolitan. Love the front. The inside is okay. The nude one, I think this is a little bit boring, but I love Nabla, so it's staying. And the Cutie Coral. It's staying as well. And all of the other palettes from Nabla. The Side by Side. This is one of my favorite palettes in my collection. This is going nowhere. This is the palette I've used most this year. I love this. It's such a good, nice... It's an amazing palette. The Soul Blooming that they discontinued. I don't understand why, because this is a really nice palette. So, yeah. The Dreamy 2 and Dreamy 1. This was their first palette. This is actually really nice. I'm going to try to use this more next year. Or this year. I don't know when this is coming up. I'm filming it in the end of December. But yeah, this is staying. The same with the Dreamy 2. I though have a little hard time to use this because I don't know what to do. But I do like the color story. It's a really nice color story. Then I have this one, the single bundle they released a couple of years ago. I like this one. And I always had it like an eyeshadow palette. It's really, really good. I think they have the same formula on their single shadows as on their eyeshadow palettes. The Poison Garden got a lot of hate. It's not the best they have done, but if we take away this blue shade, I think this is a good palette. It's not amazing, but I have nothing against it at all. And then my favorite palette, Side by Side, with a Side by Side, it's the Secret palette. It's an amazing palette. I love everything about this. I can really recommend this if you want to try Nabla. I think it's really, really good, the Secret palette. Really, really good. Then I have my only Natasha Denona palette. This is a mini palette. I'm actually thinking of buying a big one. I'm saying that in the decluttering video. This is the Mini Love. And I did not maybe understand what the hype is. But at the same time, this is 5 shadows. And at the same time, I still want to buy a bigger one. I actually think that I will decluttering this one. I've used it once. I didn't film with it. But I actually will see if one of my friends want this one. Because I do not want it. No. I'm decluttering this one. My only Natasha Denona. I have 2 palettes from Nomad. I wish that I had more, but I do not. I have the Tokyo Harajuku. It's a really fun palette. It's not the best pastel palette, but it is a really, really fun palette. Some of these shades are amazing, like this purple and this orange. They are amazing. And this pink is really good. And also these two are really nice. And here it's multichromes in the last row. And yeah, I do like this and I'm going to save it. This is like the cutest palette I have. And it just makes me happy. Then I have the Oriental Express that is filled with cat hair. I have used this once, but I won't save it because I want to use it more. More catcher. Yeah, this is staying. Then I have two palettes from NYX that are both going. This is a little palette that I have never used. Color Riot. I don't even know why I bought it. I'm not going to keep this. And then I have this Vivid Brights. What's it called? Brights? Vivid Brights. That's... this is so bad. Some people do really love this. I do not know why. I'm going to declutter this one. It is shit. From Oden's Eye, I have two palettes. I have Urd that I haven't tried yet. I'm going to use this soon. And then I have the Giant Wolves that is a collab with Annette from Annette's Makeup Corner. And this palette, it is amazing. I love how dark it is. I love the shimmers, especially this one is such a nice shimmer, and also this green one. And the dark shades are amazing. So both of these are staying. I really do like these. These are the only ones from Oden's side that I've tried, but I do really, really like them. My palettes from Shroud, these are also staying as well, but I can show you them. This is the Creepy Cute with the hardest magnet in the world. This is an amazing pastel palette. If you want pastels, buy this. You will never find better pastels than this. The Divinity palette, that I do like, but I don't know what to do with. It is a really nice palette, but I struggle a bit with it, but it is a nice palette. One of my favorite palettes, the Arcana, is a grungy dream. I'm going to try to do a 3-looks-1 palette with this one soon. I do love everything about it. I love the grunge, I love the shimmers, some of the best shimmers in my collection. And then the It's Freaking Bats with Beauté Bean or Beauté Bean. I have the old one. I think they have changed this now to Beauté Bean. I have Beauté Bean. I love this one. It is such a cool palette. It really screams Beauté Jean. The shadows, the shimmers are amazing. This zero is amazing. This handbook and the mattes are just so fun. I love this one. This is going nowhere. Okay, we are so soon done. I have 3 palettes from TheBalm. And now we are coming into the palettes that like you never see on my channel. So I have the Meet Matte palette. This is the Meet Matte Nude. This is the first one. I do really have been loving this. But I'm going to decluttering this one. The same with the Meet Matte Trimony. I'm not keeping this one either. And then I have Meet Matte Adore. I'm not keeping this either. It was a time in my life when I did love these 3 palettes. Thought it was the best palettes ever, but not anymore. So these 3 are going. This is not what I like anymore. Then I have this collab palette with Too Faced and Kat Von D. The Too Faced palette, or the Too Faced side, because they are... You can take them apart. The Too Faced side is one of the best, I almost said, one of the worst eyeshadow palettes I have ever tried. But the Kat Von D side, this, I have saved it only because of this red one. But I have other reds now that I like more and that I want to use. So it's finally time for this one to leave my collection. And I'm not going to be sad about it at all. So this is going. One of the last brands, Urban Decay. I have the Kristen Leanne Kaleidoscope Dream? Kaleidoscope? This palette, I hated it when it came out. I was like, what the fuck is this? But it's actually really good. The shadows are really good. So this one is staying. The layout, maybe not, but it's staying. Then I have the other little palette they did together. I don't even know what this is called. Daydream. I think I've used this once. even the lip brush has the plastic on. I'm going to declutter in this one. It's going. And then, okay, I don't know. I think I have tried to declutter some of these palettes before, but I haven't. I put them back in my collection again. But this is the ultimate basic. That looks like this. It's time for this one to go. Yeah. I'm not going to undo this. And like, what, do you see how thin these shades are? I don't know, Urban Decay. Sometimes I think you are high on crack. Then I have the Gwen Stefani palette. This one I got from my boyfriend for Christmas. This is going to stay in my collection because it's got sentimental value to me. So this is staying. Then I have the Moon Dust. And I've been hating this for so long. But I've started to like it. So it's staying in my collection. We don't need to talk about that more. And then I have the Naked 2 and 3. And I think I have tried to decluttering these like 2 times. They have always found their way back. So the Naked 2 palette was my first expensive palette that I bought. I bought this in London a lot of years ago, but now I actually think it's time for this to go. I can't save too much for sentimental value, so it's time for this one to go. And this one, it's also time for this one to go. It's the Naked 3. I don't even think these are available anymore, maybe the Naked 2. But this is not staying. These are really good shadows. I did really fall in love with these, but they are not, this time they are not going to survive. I can just say it like that. And the last palette for this super long video is this one from ZOEVA. This is ZOEVA Matte. I have used this once, had it for a long time, so this is not staying. I do think it's nice. If I wouldn't been a colorful makeup lover, I think I would love this, but I am a colorful makeup lover, so this is going. And you know what? That was all my eyeshadow palettes. So I'm going to see the maybe pile has become the same as my decluttering pile. So I think I would just decluttering everything. Yeah. So I'm going to see how many I decided to declutter. Okay, so it's 39 that I'm decluttering, and this was maybe the Beauty Bay, but I'm actually decluttering this one. The only thing is now, wouldn't it be awesome if I did decluttering 40 eyeshadow palettes? I have missed some. 40. 41 and 42. So I did decluttering 42 eyeshadow palettes. So I'm going to count how many I do have left, and then yeah, we will see how many eyeshadow palettes I have. But 42 is leaving my collection, and it feels really good. I hope I can get more of an order now. 43 is leaving my collection. Jesus, I have mixed everything. So 43 palettes is leaving my collection. Okay, I'm going to declutter 42 because this is going to stay. So 42 is out of this collection. Now I have decided. 42 is out. So that was almost all of my palettes, because between the time where I filmed the decluttering, four more palettes has come into my collection, so I thought that I can show you them now. So the first one is from LH Cosmetic, and this is the new Golden 20s. This was half off at a point in Sweden during December, so I actually decided to buy it. And it looks like this. This is the only palette they have done that is in plastic. I don't know what I like about this. This looks very blend, maybe. But the part of me is like, I have all the eyeshadow palettes from LH Cosmetics, but I didn't have this. It was half off, so I was like, okay, I'm going to buy it. So this has come into my collection. Also, a new Natasha Denona palette, which is the palette that I used today. This is the retro palette. So this is one of the mid palettes, I guess, with 15 shades. So it looks like this, and I did enjoy using it. Do I think it's worth all the money? Maybe not, but I did get 20% off, so I'm happy about that, and I do like the look. And the last two palettes is two palettes from a Swedish brand, that is GlossGods. And these are some, maybe like special effects palettes, no, but some duochromes, yeah, 12 pan effect eyeshadow palettes. And this is Gal on Mars. Maybe I should take out the plastic. So this is Gallon March, and these have some duochromes in it, maybe multichromes even. And the Swedish beauty community did rave about these, and they did restock them, so I decided to buy them. So that is the Gal on Mars, and this is Gal on the Moon. This is a bluish one. Doing purple. It looks like this, and I'm so looking forward to use this to like see what I can create with them. So there will come videos with these soon. So in total I have 125 palettes. I wished at some point that I maybe could go lower than 100 palettes or around 100 palettes, but I have 125 eyeshadow palettes. That is my eyeshadow palette and decluttering video. I really hope that you liked this one, and I hope that you're happy that you finally did get to see all my palettes. So yeah, if you're not subscribing to my channel, please do, so you don't miss any of my videos, and I hope I'll see you in the next one. Bye!